Okay. Let's take a look now. And what I want to do now is I want to talk about analysis of financial statements. Okay? We know how to prepare them, hopefully. Okay? But going to this. Okay, we know how to prepare a cash flow statement. What does this all mean? What does this all mean? Well, that's a good question. Okay? To kind of take you into this, let me do a little analogy here. All right? Let's say that we have three new graduates, and they're three new graduates from the university, and they have their accounting degrees. We have Nancy, Scott, and Ted, and they are all determined that they are going to make it big. Okay? And so they decide to have a contest. And the contest is this: which person can increase their personal balance of cash the most in 1 year? Okay? Who can increase their personal balance of cash the most in 1 year? Okay? So you understand the challenge here? Well, a year goes by, and the results are in. Okay? Nancy increased her cash balance by $50,000 even. Scott also increased his cash balance by $50,000. What a coincidence. And if you think that's a coincidence, wait till you see this. Ted also increased his cash balance by $50,000. So they all increased their respective cash balances by the same amount. Is that correct? So were they all equally successful? Well, the question is how did each person accomplish this increase in cash? All right, well, Nancy increased her cash balance. She started her own consulting business, and her first year revenues were in excess of $110,000. Now, obviously, that's not the same as her cash increase because she had expenses there, right? Okay. So she started her own consulting business, had revenues in excess of $110,000. Well, how did Scott accomplish his $50,000 increase in cash? Well, he sold an automobile that his parents had previously given him as a gift. And he also cashed in some of his retirement savings. But in fact, his cash did increase by $50,000. You with me? What about old Ted? Ted increased his cash balance by obtaining a loan from a local bank, and he collateralized it with equity that he had in his house. Well, can you see what I'm getting at here? What I'm getting at here is not all cash flows are equal. Is that correct? Who do you think was more successful in this? Nancy was, okay? Nancy was the most successful, okay? Now, I want you to look at this, and I want you to see that really what this is analogous to is an operating cash flow. Do you see that? Because this is cash flow generated from the operations of her new business. Okay? Am I right? Sometimes we say that cash flow that is operating is more sustainable. It's more repeatable. Okay? Maybe she will have even a better year next year, right? Okay? Now let's look at Scott. Can you see what he did? He sold an automobile and he cashed in some investments, right? Can you see where this is analogous to an investing cash flow? Isn't when we sell long-term assets, isn't that an investing cash flow? Okay. Well, is he going to be able to sell an automobile every year? No. How long can he keep cashing in retirement savings? And eventually that's going to end, right? That's not as sustainable, is it? See where I'm getting at? Okay. Ted went and got a loan, right? Okay. He wants money. He must be the American. He just goes and borrows it, right? Okay. So what kind of cash flow is this analogous to? a financing cash flow, right? This is analogous to a financing cash flow. Well, what do you think about the sustainability of this action? Is he going to be able to keep getting loans? Probably not. Probably not. So even though all three of these people individually increased their cash flows by $50,000 each, they're not equally successful, right? I think Nancy's clearly the winner here, right? Okay? Well, take that analogy and think of it as a business, okay? Let's look at an example. Let's say, and I just have a kind of an abbreviated cash flow statement for three different companies, Loggins, Traeger, and Flux. Now, each one of these companies have a net increase in cash of $15,000, okay? Now, which one, though, is most impressive? Well, let's start with Flux. Flux has a negative $24,000 from operations. Now, do you see where that's a problem, folks? Operations of your business, that's supposed to be what's generating income, generating cash flow, right? It's costing him cash to generate his, to operate his business. So when you have a net operating, when you have an operating activity and it's a negative number, that's problematic. You understand? Okay. Now, this company did, Flux did have $15,000 net increase in cash. Well, what did they do? Well, they sold some of their plant assets and they went and got a loan. Well, their cash increased, but can you see where that picture for Flux, this is not good. The operations are a net drain on cash. They're having to sell their plant assets. Well, those plant assets are probably there to help provide revenues and operate the business, right? So you start selling your plant assets, that's going to probably deter your ability to operate your business. And they're getting a loan, which they're going to have to pay back, right? Okay. Now, let's look at the one that's the most successful. The one that's most successful here is Loggins Company, okay? Well, they generated $90,000 from their operating activities. That's good, isn't it? As a rule of thumb, you like that operating number to be positive. That's why you're in business, is to conduct these operations. Now, what did they do? They had some good cash flow from their operating activities. Well, they purchased some plant assets. Hopefully they purchased these because they feel like that'll be beneficial in generating future business and revenues for their company, and hopefully cash flow as well. And what else did they do with it? Well, they repaid some debt. They repaid some debt. Those are both good things, right? So there is no doubt that the Loggins Company is the star here, and then the Flux one is sad face, right? And I would probably say Traeger is somewhere in between, okay? They do have positive operating cash flow. They were able to purchase some plant assets, right? They didn't pay off any debt. And so they're looking pretty good, but clearly I think Loggins is the winner here. Would you agree? All right? Okay, questions on that? What I want to get to is this fact right here. Investors focus on cash flows from operations more than those from investing and financing activities. And can you see why now? Cash flows from operations are seen as more sustainable, more repeatable. Okay? Cash flows from operations. Now, that's going to be abbreviated CFFO throughout the rest of this presentation. But cash flows from operations, that has the most focus from investors. Okay? Now, let's talk about cash flows from operations a little bit. This represents the cash flow, as I said, generated by the actual operations of the company. Okay? As I said, this is viewed as sustainable cash flow, something that can be repeated in future periods. Cash flows from operations, it is the most favored cash flow metric by investors. Okay? It is the one that people focus on a lot more. Okay? Now, many investors will use CFFO as sort of an alternative performance measure and favor it over accrual-based net income. Okay? Now, we're going to come back to this, but in a way, some investors might say, hey, look, I don't understand the accrual-based system. I didn't take accounting. Okay? I don't know what this matching principle is. I don't know what this revenue recognition. I want to look at your cash flows from operations because, in my opinion, if you're generating cash flows from your operations, that's good enough for me. You with me? Management knows this. Management knows that that investors focus on CFFO. Okay? However, we need to have a big caution here. First of all, please be aware that net income, which is performed on the or calculated on the accrual-based system, and CFFO, they need to be trending together. Okay? Well, what do I mean by that? Well, what I mean by that is this. Okay? If this is dollars and this is, okay, you know, if this is your net income kind of rising over time, well, your CFFO should be, it's not going to be the same number, but it should be kind of trending the same way, right? Are you with me? Now, there has been situations where the exact opposite happened. One number was going this way, and the other number was going this way. And sometimes this is net income and this is CFFO, and sometimes this is CFFO and this is net income. This is a problem, and you should be concerned. Okay? These should trend together. Okay? All right. Ask me any questions as we go along if you have them. Okay, another thing we need to be cautious about is this. Do not be fooled into thinking that cash flow cannot be manipulated. Okay? Come off that for a second. When I teach Accounting 1, I tell them very quickly we're going to use the accrual basis of accounting. And I teach them the revenue recognition principle, the matching principle. And some students think, I think it'd be easier to manipulate it if you use the accrual basis, right? Because you might be recognizing revenue, you haven't even received the cash yet, right? No. It is easier to manipulate things with a cash basis. Because think about it. At the end of the year, couldn't I say to my people, don't pay any bills. Don't pay any bills in December. We'll worry about it in January, the new fiscal year. But we want to make things look as good as they can. Okay? Or you could also, customers are prepaying you for services or products that you have not yet received. You're receiving cash flow. We'll provide the products and services later. Just give us the money now. Do you see how easy it would be to manipulate? Okay? The cash basis of accounting is something that can really be manipulated. Okay? Now, there are people who haven't had accounting classes who don't understand this, and they think quite the opposite. They think, well, the reason I focus on the cash flow statement is I know cash flow cannot be manipulated. Cash is either coming in or it's going out. That's a dangerous way of thinking. Now, I'm not saying the cash flow statement is not useful. It is very useful. But you can't go into it thinking these erroneous ideas. cash flow can be manipulated. I just gave you two examples of it, right? Okay. Holding off on bills and trying to collect early. All right? Okay. All right. Another thing we need to be cautious about. Management knows that investors scrutinize cash flow from operations. And some of their choices that management makes, it can be influenced by a desire to present a favorable CFFO to investors. You see what I'm saying? They know that CFFO is the most favored son. It's the one that people really want to look good. Yeah, investing and financing, you want those to look too, but we really want cash flow from operations to look good. Are you with me? Well, where does that lead us? Well, we have a problem. The rules on how to classify cash flows are sometimes a little bit vague, okay? And international accounting rules, if anybody's watching this and they live in a different country, please know that some international rules for how you classify cash flows vary. For example, payment of taxes with United States generally accepted accounting principles is always an operating activity. There's other countries where sometimes it's a financing or an investing activity, okay? Another one, I think we treat dividends received as an operating cash flow. Some companies treat it as a financing cash flow. Now, there's not a lot of differences, but be aware, if you're comparing two different companies and one's international, they might have slightly different rules, okay? But let's go back to this. Let's not focus on international. Let's focus on the fact that management knows that people scrutinize CFFO closer, and they have some latitude in how they classify it. Some of the rules are not as black and white as perhaps they should be. Okay? So here's the situation that you get into. Let me do a little analogy here. Let's say we have a barrel of apples. Okay? Now, some of the apples are red and they look delicious. Okay? And there's a few in there, though, that are not so good of apples. Okay? These kind of these yellow and brown ones, right? Kind of smell a little bit, right? And you know, hey, that's how life is. Life gives us some good apples. Life gives us some bad apples, right? And every company is going to have some good apples and some bad apples, as far as some good things and some bad things, right? Well, what management does is this. They know that people are focusing on the part of the barrel that they can see most easily. So what do you think they do with these bad apples? Well, they push those down a little bit. They put those down here, okay? Oh, look at that barrel of apples. Well, that barrel of apples is actually the same as this barrel of apples. All they have done is taken these stinky apples and put them down in the basket that's not as easily seen, okay? Well, the analogy here is those red apples that are on top that are most visible, those are your operating cash flows. You want those to look nice. And those stinky apples, they don't make us look so good. Those are our investing and financing cash flows. Let's see if we can push that stuff down to what's not so easily noticed. You see what I'm saying? Management wants to make their CFFO look nice. Okay?